6 Minute English from BBC Learning English.
Hello, this is 6 Minute English from BBC Learning English. I'm Neil.
And I'm Sam.
In this programme, we'll be looking at an unusual food called microalgae and asking whether eating algae might be better for our health and the health of the planet. And, of course, we'll be looking at some of the related vocabulary along the way.
Yuck. I'm not sure about eating algae, Neil. I mean, what's the strangest thing you've ever eaten?
Well, I once tried fried stick insects in Thailand, and I've had ants as well that were from Colombia.
Both fairly strange for us here in the UK. But what about pond scum, Neil?
Pond scum. Pond scum is the slang name for microalgae, green plant organisms such as spirulina, which grow in water, like ponds, and look a bit slimy or scummy before being dried. Here we're talking about edible algae, meaning it's okay to eat.
More than okay. In fact, these types of food algae are actually good for your body. Microalgae like spirulina and chlorella are packed full of proteins, vitamins, and antioxidants. Because they are so healthy, they're having a moment right now, meaning they are becoming more well-known and popular.
Yes, microalgae is trending just now, and for good reasons, which we'll find out about later. But first, let me ask you our quiz question. What do the following three things have in common? Oceans, snow, and my garden patio. Is it A, they are all good places to relax? B, they are all very cold? Or C, they are all places where microalgae grow?
Okay, well, I know that oceans and snow are made up of water, but your garden patio, did your barbecue get rained off again, Neil?
Not quite, Sam. Okay. Well, hopefully you'll know by the end of the programme. Now, I mentioned before that microalgae is sometimes called a superfood, a type of food which is essentially full of healthy vitamins, minerals and nutrients. But microalgae is not the first superfood to become popular.
That's right. In the early 2010s, many juice bars started popping up in places around the world selling green smoothies, energy drinks made by blending healthy ingredients like kale, chard and spinach. The recent trend for microalgae and spirulina has been promoted in part by big drinks companies wanting to sell the latest brightly coloured smoothies.
And more, spirulina is also being used as a cooking ingredient in hot dogs and meatballs and as a protein-rich substitute for eggs in pasta and mayonnaise.
But as well as all these health benefits, there's another advantage to microalgae superfoods, one that could potentially benefit the whole planet. BBC Radio 4's The Food Programme asked Professor Alison Smith, head of plant sciences at Cambridge University, to explain.
As the population of the world increases and the land that's available for agriculture is becoming stretched, there's an interest in trying to increase productivity by other means. So sustainable intensification of agriculture is one way.
So food security is an issue, making sure enough nutritionally rich food is produced to feed the growing world population. Alison Smith says the amount of agricultural land available for growing food is becoming stretched, meaning there are not enough resources, in this case farmland, to meet everyone's needs.
Yes, and she mentions that one possible solution is sustainable intensification of agriculture, which means increasing food production in ways which don't damage the environment or use new land.
Well, we know that microalgae are superfoods, nutritionally rich in vitamins and protein, but how do they help reduce the need for agricultural land? Alison Smith explains.
They can be grown in all sorts of locations, in water, in the oceans, in ponds, lakes and so on, even on your patio and on snow. So one of the possibilities is to produce these organisms in cities and towns because they don't need the open landscape to be grown.
I think I've spotted the answer to your quiz question, Neil.
Oh yes, I asked what oceans, snow and my patio have in common. A, they are all good places to relax. B, they are all very cold. C, they are all places where microalgae grow.
The answer is C, places where microalgae can grow. What an amazing plant. I think I'm going to stop calling it pond scum and use the correct scientific name Professor Smith mentioned, organisms.
Today's programme was all about microalgae, like spirulina, a green, edible food algae, which some people call pond scum, although scientifically speaking, it's an organism, meaning an animal or plant life form.
Yes, and this plant life form is also called a superfood because it's especially rich in vitamins, minerals, and nutrients which promote good health.
Superfoods are having a moment right now, meaning they're becoming more popular or trending because they're so healthy.
And another benefit of microalgae is that it grows almost anywhere. So it doesn't use much agricultural land, which is becoming stretched, meaning there's not enough of it to meet the world's food needs. Sustainable intensification is another possible solution to this problem because it is a way of increasing food production without harming the environment or using new land. Don't forget, you can find lots more learning materials and topical vocabulary on our website at bbclearningenglish.com. And please join us again soon. Bye for now.
Bye.
6 Minute English from bbclearningenglish.com.
Hi everyone, we hope you enjoyed that video and thank you very much for watching. We have so many more just like it, so if you don't want to miss a single one, make sure to subscribe and we will see you regularly. Hope to see you soon. Bye guys.